Today's content creators have to create or repurpose content for multiple platforms, and this can be quite challenging. But with Adobe Premiere Pro's auto reframe sequence, this makes the job much easier. So let's look at how you can do that in Adobe Premiere Pro. Go up to the menu at the top and find auto reframe sequence. In the dialog box, you can rename your sequence, but Adobe Premiere Pro does a good job of renaming your sequence. Then you can choose an aspect ratio. In that same dialog box, you can see that you can also choose how fast Premiere Pro tracks what it determines to be your main subject. Because once your sequence is reframed, Premiere Pro tries to follow any action that's going on in the scene, and it determines which is the most important part of the scene and tracks that. Sometimes the program doesn't quite track the right subject, and you have to make manual adjustments in the effects control panel that comes next. The last option in this dialog box asks you whether you want to nest your clips or not. I usually just leave it in the default setting. Once you've applied your auto reframe, Adobe Premiere Pro will create a new sequence, and you can go to the effects control panel, and this is where you can now tweak your reframe so that it is perfect. First and foremost, you can actually turn the whole effect off completely if for whatever reason you decide you want to reframe the sequence manually. But you can also override the tracking of individual parameters or individual clips. With the effect on, you can adjust the tracking between default, slower, and faster. This is similar to what you had in the first dialog box, but you can make further adjustments if you find that your tracking is not that great. Faster motion tracking is for dynamic content, but the default works fine for most situations. The next thing you can adjust is the position, but usually I just leave this because this is only if you want to animate your sequence. The next thing you can adjust is the scale. This is how much the content is zoomed in or out to fill the aspect ratio. To adjust your reframe so that your subject is in the center, if Adobe Premiere has missed that, you can use this reframe offset to move left and right in the frame. So with auto reframe, Premiere Pro takes the hard work out of resizing your videos. The program does most of the work for you, and then you can go in and tweak and fine-tune the adjustments for perfect framing. Let me know if you found this video useful. If you have, then please subscribe, like, and share the video, and make sure you click the notification bell for more tips on general media production.